there, right? Yeah, you can open your video, ma, everyone. I want to see all your faces. Yes. Namaste, children. I'm Sangeeta. I'm your science 2 mentor. Okay. So we are going to see the first lesson in science 2, that is plant anatomy and plant physiology. Okay. So before we go into this plant anatomy and plant physiology, we just want to know, why do we study this lesson? Okay. So why do we study this lesson? To care for the plants and fight plant diseases. So why to care for plants and plant diseases and all? Because the plant is dying. Yes, you can shake your head, right? If you understand. So that I can see you people. Okay, so the plant is the main producer in the world. All the plant, animal, or human, all if you see the ecosystem itself, we are all depend upon the main producer itself, it's a plant. Okay, so we should care for the plant, right? And we should fight against this plant disease, because nowadays you may have so much of diseases that has been attaching the plant. So prevent such plant species, so we should know about the anatomy and the physiology of the plant. Okay, so what would be the meaning of this anatomy and physiology? So anatomy means the branch of biology concerned with the internal structure and the parts of the plant. Okay, so the internal structure and the parts of the plant, that is being called as what? Anatomy. Okay, and the functioning of the plants, functioning in the sense of how it functions and all, they prepare its own food, right, for the growth, and it absorb all the water, minerals, everything, all those functions that happen inside, the transpiration process, photosynthesis, everything that happens, you know, so that is said to be the functioning of the plants. Okay, so the cellular level, sectioning of the tissues and absorbed through the microscope. Last year itself, we would have seen most of the tissues, right? What are the tissues we saw through the microscope? Parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma, it's a thing. You remember? Yeah. So those are all meant to be the physiology. Okay. So this anatomy, the branch of biology that concerned with the internal structure and the parts of plants, it generally called this anatomy, plant anatomy. In short form, it is being called as phytotomy. What is this? Phytotomy. Okay, so now, before we go into that, we should know the first rough flowchart. See, this one is a, you know, what is the first single cellular organism that has been evolved in this world? Obviously, that is your water. Panaceum, amoeba, right? So right from single cell, we have the multicellular. So highest multicellular complex structure we found in the humans, animals, plants, and all, right? So most of the group cells that will be formed, the group to form what? A living thing. Okay, so here the group of cells that performs in one place, no, that is said to be the tissues. The group of tissues that is being called an organ. The group of organs that is being called as an organ system. You understood? So next slide. The classification of the tissue system was first brought down by France in 1875. Who brought down the classification of the tissue system? Starts in 1875. And these degrees of organization, which are the degrees of the organization? Group of cells, tissue form of group of tissues that form the body, group of organs that perform the organ system. No. So these are the degrees of the organization. So these degrees of the organization, no? Who brought down? He was an English physician. His name is Nehemiah Crewe. Okay, so these degrees of organization was brought down by whom? The English physician Nehemiah Crewe. Okay, and he was just mentioned as a father of plant anatomy. Okay, so he was mentioned as a father of plant anatomy. So we're coming to the recalling the previous knowledge. Okay, so last year we would have studied regarding plant anatomy and physiology in your science school, right? So what could be the two types of tissues? we study meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Right? Yes. So meristematic tissue or the permanent tissue are the two types of tissues. So what is the meristematic tissue? Meristematic. Meristematic itself means dividing. Permanent means it won't divide. So meristematic tissue is the immature cells that is capable of undergoing cell division. Okay, so you can find out all those meristematic tissue at the growing part of the plant. Okay, so the permanent tissue that can be seen in the older part of the plant. Okay, where the growth has been completely stopped for a short period of time. You understood? So this was the thing we studied. Leia, am I right or not? Yes? Yes? Meristematic tissue and the permanent tissue. So the meristematic tissue has been classified into two types. What are they? Simple tissue and complex tissue. Simple tissue and complex tissue. Simple tissue means structurally and functionally, they are performing the similar cells. So we studied in that simple tissue only all the parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma and dot. Yeah. So again, for the complex tissue, it's made up of more than one type of cells. Okay, so it's made up of more than one type of cells. In the complex tissue, the colenchyma only the parenchyma. Yeah. So these are the things we studied in the last 9th standard. Right. So now we are going to study about the three types of tissue system. What are the three types of tissue system? First one is dermal or epidermal. Second is ground tissue. Third is vascular tissue. Okay. What is the first one? Dermal or epidermal, ground tissue, and vascular tissue. You can open open your mouth and say, okay. I can see all your video and all. Okay, so just follow me. How does the functioning of these tissues happen? Okay, so first we see the first classification. What is the first classification? Tell me, dermal or epidermal. So now we are going to see about the dermal or epidermal. Epi itself means what? It's an outermost. Okay, in skin, the skin in our body, we call it as epidermis, right? Yes, epidermis itself means what? Outer skin. So the outer skin of the plant, that is the epidermal tissue system, you are going to see. So it is the outermost layer. And this outermost layer has so much of pores. Okay, so what would be the pores that is being called as? What could be the pores that is called as? Stomata. Very good, very good. Stomata. So stomata means what? We have studied in a small age and all, right? Right from 6th standard, we are studying about stomata. It helps in what process, mom? It helps in what process? Huh? Yes, transpiration. Yes. So, you all how the stomata open and close. It removes excess of water. Large cells, molema, remove control, excess of water. Okay, that could be the transpiration process. And also, it has root hairs. What it has? Root hairs. These are all you can see in the outermost layer of the plant. It has a pores for stomata and also it has a root hairs. Root hairs where you can see the root. Okay, at the root you can see some minute structures, right? So that could be the root hairs. So those root hairs are function in the absorption of the water and minerals. What could be the function of that root hairs? Come on, let's see. Absorption of the water and minerals. Okay, so coming to the function of the epidermal tissue system. What could be the function's main function? Protection and transpiration. Protection means it giving a safeguarding to the entire organ system. Okay, so it's outer layer. Okay, so that could be the protection. And transpiration has no industrial staff. So, that is the stomata. Using stomata, the transpiration process will occur. Next slide, we see about the ground tissue. Okay, so the previous slide, we saw the three types of tissue system. So first one we saw, dermal or epidermal. So it is related to the skin. Now we are going to see about the ground tissue. Okay, ground tissue. What are the tissues that are involved in this? Parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Right, so ground tissue we'll see. So this ground tissue, it has been found in all parts of the plant, okay, except in epidermis and in vascular tissue.
Okay, apart from this epidermis and vascular tissue, this ground tissue, it has been seen in all parts of the plants. So what could be the functions of this ground tissue? You already know the photosynthesis, right? What happened? Yes, you already know the photosynthesis, right? You have studied in the small age, right? From sixth standard, you have been studying the photosynthesis. What could be the photosynthesis process? You're utilizing the sunlight and the green color pigment, the chlorophyll, the plant, it prepares its own food. Okay, so that is the photosynthesis, right? Yes? Yeah. And also, this photosynthesis and food storage. Okay, it will store its food and regenerating for the plant. Okay, and support. Support means the strength, the stem, that support and protection. The outer protecting epidermal tissue. Okay, so these are all the functions of the ground tissue. Then coming to the vascular tissue. So we studied two classification. What are they? First classification is the dermal or epidermal. Second classification is ground tissue. This ground tissue we can see in all parts of the plant body except epidermis and vascular tissue. And vascular tissue, it is also well known for you people. I have already shown in the 9th standard slide, xylem and phloem. Yes, you remember? Xylem and phloem. So xylem would function in a, that is a transporting the water and the minerals. What is the function of the xylem? It will transport. Come on, let's see. It will transport water and the minerals. And phloem would function in a, it will transport only the food. Okay. Then, so this xylem and phloem, it can be seen in the form of bundle. What type of bundle it is? It is called a vascular bundle. Okay, so the xylem and phloem can be seen in the form of bundles. So this type of bundle is said to be the vascular bundle. This vascular bundle are of three types. What are they? Radial, conjoint, concentrate. Okay, what are the three types of vascular bundle? Let's say radial, conjoint, and concentrate. Okay, so if you see the radial means, it's already in your book. Okay, I'll show you the picture later on. Now you just know about these classifications. So radial means, here you can see the xylem and phloem arranged in the different radii, okay, alternative radii. Okay, so that is what it is called as radial vascular bundle. Then conjoint. Conjoint means the xylem and phloem that has been arranged in the same radius. If you see the book means you can able to have an idea. I'll show you the picture later on. Okay. And concentric means the concentric in turn it is being classified into two types. What are they? Amphivascular and amphicribral. What are they? Amphivascular and amphicribral. Okay, this conjoint, in turn, it has been classified into two types. Just know the pronunciation and dot. Collateral and bicollateral. What are they? Collateral and bicollateral. Okay, so if you see in this collateral means, the xylem lies towards the center. Okay, and if you see, the phloem means, the phloem will be in the periphery. Okay,